quadratic equations.
Okay, quadratic equation is there, and your exam is in June. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Maha. June first week, like starting June.
Yes, ma'am. First week.
Okay. Okay, June. Rest of the student, please let me know. And the
ma'am,
chapter
my
is
exam
quadratic.
on, ma'am, my exam is on the
Galvin, what are you saying?
For my exam, it's on 28th.
28th of May.
Yes, ma'am. This
and what is the syllabus for that?
Real numbers, polynomials, and pair of linear equations in two variables. Three chapters.
Real number, polynomial, and pair of
and
third
pair of
pair of
linear
linear
equations
equation.
In two variables.
May 28th, you are saying, right, Galvin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, Harshit, you were saying something. Harshit?
Yes, ma'am. My exams are starting on 1st July.
Preference?
Ma'am, the syllabus will be shared soon.
Can you please repeat again, Harshit?
I'm saying that in maths, they are coming on just 5 chapters.
The first 5 chapters.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so real number is there, polynomial is there, pair of linear equation is there, which is done in your batch, right?
Yes.
And quadratic equation is the remaining one, and after that, the 5th chapter. Okay, quadratic equation, that means if we'll be taking this one, this will be helpful for you. Okay, rest of the student?
So, ma'am.
Yes, Ziana.
Exam is starts June 3rd.
Mm-hmm.
And the first 4 chapters and the 5th chapter exercise 5.1 and 5.2.
First 4 chapter and?
And the 5th chapter's exercise 5.1 and 2.
Is there in your exam and which is going to be held in June, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Harshit, you said July, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, so quadratic equation will be helpful for Ziana, you as well. Rest of the students, anyone else is there? Aisha?
Yes, ma'am.
Any preference?
Same, ma'am. Same, like real number, polynomial, and quadratic equations.
Who said quadratic? Aisha, you said quadratic equation?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, fine. So Maya is going to join. Hi, Sumaya. Can you hear me? Am I audible to you, Sumaya? Can you hear me, Sumaya? Okay, so based on the above observation, I can see that if we'll be starting this chapter for quadratic equation, it will be helpful for you all, right? And yes, Galvin, pair of linear equation. From when you are having your exam, Galvin?
Ma'am, the 28th.
28th of May, right?
May. Ma'am, this month.
Okay. So we are going to create an extra class, extra batch. There we'll be discussing this topic, pair of linear equation. Okay. And we are going to invite all the students, whoever have not done this chapter. Okay, Galvin, don't worry. Parallelly, we are going to create one batch where we are going to discuss this pair of linear equation. Here in our this batch, we will be starting this with this quadratic equation because this is the preference of most of the student. And before their exam, like we will take three, four class and we'll be done with this chapter. So after this chapter, if we have to take chapter 5 also, don't worry, we will be able to finish it before the exam. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so let's start with the discussion. Sumaya, you have not said anything. See, here I have written each and every student's preference that they are having their upcoming exam, and in the exam, what is which chapter is going to come. So the chapter which we have already covered, fine. The chapter which we have still not started, okay, they have Maha said the quadratic equation, if we'll start, it will be helpful for her. Galvin said this chapter, Harshit also given, Ziana also given her preference. And what about you, Sumaya?
Quadratic equations.
Quadratic equation. Okay, fine. Let's start with quadratic equation. In our other batch, we are going to start with the probability. So if anyone, check your syllabus one more time. If you are having that chapter also, you can join in this that batch also. Okay.
Teacher, how do you join in that batch? The one you're doing probability?
If it is going to come in your upcoming exam, then only you can join in that batch. Okay. And if in the upcoming exam it's not there, so just we'll be covering step by step your chapter, like quadratic equation and then chapter 5. And if you want to join for probability, let us know our operation team that you are having probability in for your upcoming exam and you want to join the batch where probability is going to start. Today only I'm going to start in our, just a second. Yeah, today only I'm going to start it in our 9:30 batch. Okay. So anyone from here want to join, please join over there. 9:30 IST. Okay. And one time, just once inform our operation team as well that this is what you are having. You will get the link of that batch. Okay. Is it okay? Quadratic equation, we are going to start. Quadratic equations. This is what we are going to start today. And this word quadratic is already known to you. You are familiar with this word quadratic. See carefully. When the degree of the polynomial is 2, it's called quadratic polynomial. When the degree of the polynomial is 2, it's called quadratic polynomial. Are we going to talk about that polynomial only in terms of equation? Equation means there has to be an equality sign. Okay. And quadratic, you already know, degree 2. Okay. So yes, we are going to talk about the same quadratic. Here also in our quadratic equation, the highest power of the variable will be 2, and we will be having equation over here. Whenever this word equation will be there, that means there has to be equality sign. Equality sign will be there. That's why we say that be careful if we are writing 2xy plus 20. This is not an equation. This is a algebraic expression. It's an expression. And what about equation? If I'll write equals to anything, 0, 20, 30, whatever. Once I have given this equality sign, it became equation. Okay, if I'm going to write equals to 10, now this algebraic expression, previously the left hand side, we were calling it algebraic expression. Now this became equation. So here we are going to talk about quadratic equation. So quadratic is known to us, any polynomial where the degree of the polynomial is 2, that is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. If this type of polynomial we were having, we called it quadratic. Here also we are going to talk about this quadratic only, an equation, that means there will be equality sign. Apart from equality sign, there will be zero also on the other side. So it will be ax square plus bx plus c is equals to zero. This is the standard form of quadratic equation. The standard form of quadratic equation. Okay. Now, here we'll be having few questions like this one. Let me give example like this. If we are having 8x square plus 20, is it a quadratic equation? Yes, it's a quadratic equation. Recall that when we were talking about the degree of the polynomial, highest degree of the polynomial, when it is 2, it's called quadratic. So when we were having ax square, highest degree of the polynomial 2. When we were having ax square plus bx, highest degree of the polynomial over here 2. When we were having ax square plus bx plus c, still highest degree of the polynomial is 2 over here, okay, for the first example, for the second example, for the third example. So here you can understand that even if bx is not there, fine. Even if c is not there, fine. Still it is quadratic. Still the name is quadratic. Quadratic because this power 2 is there. But if this term will not be there, if this term will not be there, that is just bx plus c is there. Now it is. Now, what is the degree of this polynomial bx plus c? Degree of the polynomial is? Let me know. Bx plus c, degree of the polynomial is?
1.
Exactly. Is it quadratic?
No.
It's not. Degree of the polynomial became 1. It's not quadratic. So, to become a quadratic, ax square, this x square term has to be there. Okay, x square has to be there. Apart from that, bx is there, fine. C is there, fine. Other terms are there, fine. Even if it's not there, fine. Still it's quadratic. If I am writing 3x square, it's quadratic. Quadratic polynomial. Okay, if I'll be writing only x square, it is quadratic. Here, if I'll be adding a number that is 20, it's quadratic. Okay. Here, if I will add 5x plus 20, it's quadratic. Okay. But just 5x plus 20, it's not quadratic. Just 20, it's not quadratic. So to be a quadratic, degree 2, the maximum power of the variable 2 has to be there for the polynomial, for the equation also. Okay. So we are going to talk about this equation only, quadratic equation. Now the standard format, if you will focus on the standard format of the quadratic equation, you can see carefully that here we are having ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. Other side 0 has to be there. Okay, if it is not there, we will make it 0. Let's say our equation is 8x square plus 20 is equals to 35. So one side, any one of the side, we will make 0. Okay. So we are going to write 8x square plus 20, and that 35 we are going to bring to another side. We are going to transpose it towards the left hand side. So it will become minus 35 over here and is equals to 0. This is how we are going to make it or represent it in the form of standard format. So it will be 8x square 20 minus 35 is 20 minus 35 is anyone plus 20 minus 35 is what?
Minus 15.
Minus 15 is equals to 0. This is our standard format of quadratic equation. One of the side, always we will maintain 0. If 0 is not there, any other number is there, we will transpose it. We will transpose it to other side. Okay. And then we'll be able to represent it in a standard format. Now here, if the question will be, what is A? What is B? What is C? A, B, C means compare it with the standard format. That is AX square plus BX plus C. And then fine. Do the comparison and then tell that what is A, what is B, and what is C. Can you tell me what is A, what is B, and what is C just by doing the comparison? If I am writing the standard format of the quadratic equation is AX square plus BX plus C. See the pink one. Okay, the pink one will not be given to you. We must know that this is the standard format. Okay, and if A, B, C is asked in the question, we will be able to say that whatever is the coefficient of x square, that's A. Whatever is the coefficient of x, that's B. Whatever is the constant number, that's C. With with its proper sign, positive or negative. Now tell me, what is A over here?
8.
8. Perfect. What is B?
0.
Exactly. B is 0. Be careful, everyone. Rest of the student, B is 0 over here. See, C said it perfectly, that B will be 0 because we don't have any X and coefficient of X is 0 because we don't have any X over here. Or in our imagination, we are thinking that 8X square plus 0 into X minus 15, this structure is there. Okay, 0 into X must be sitting over there. If no X is there, that means maybe the coefficient is 0. Or the other way of understanding the concept is, if you can't see BX over here, if you can't see X term over here, then definitely the coefficient of X will be 0. Okay, what is C over here?
Minus 15.
Minus 15. Perfect. This is how we will be, our equation will be given. We are going to write it in the standard format. How? By maintaining other side 0, because we have to be careful. This is the standard. The rectangular box one is the standard format of quadratic equation. Equation, equality sign is there, and after equality sign, 0 is there, which has to be there. Okay. Ax square bx plus c is equals to 0. If other side 0 is not there in our question, no worries, we will take it. We will transpose it and we will make one of the side as a 0. Okay. Now, after that, if the coefficient is asked, that is ABC is asked in the question, we will be able to find ABC and we'll be able to write it like this. The way she said that C is negative 15, we have to be careful that C is negative 15, not just only 15. Okay, it's not 15, it's not positive 15, it's negative 15, be careful. Okay, is it clear to everyone? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay, just give me a second. Now the question will be like this also, that check whether the following are quadratic equations. Check it whether the following are quadratic equations, yes or no. How we are going to check? Let's check it. The first one is x minus 2 whole square plus 1 is equals to twice x minus 3. Next one, x plus 1 plus 8 is equals to x plus 2, x minus 2. Okay. One more we are having. X twice x plus 3, x square plus 1, and the other one is x plus 2 whole cube is equals to x cube minus 4. Let's do it one by one. See the instruction carefully, okay? In mathematics, we will always read the instruction carefully. Whatever be the question, even if it looks like very simple, we are going to read the instruction very carefully. Check whether the following are quadratic equation. Yes or no, we have to say. Whether the first one, is it a quadratic equation? Just by looking the equation, we are going to say no. We have to do the simplification. And if we will be able to represent it in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, then we will say it's quadratic. Now be careful, what we discuss, x square term has to be there. Then only the name quadratic will come. If you will find after solving it, after simplifying it, that x square term is not even there, then it's not quadratic. Okay, so let's do the simplification over here. Now x minus 2 whole square. It looks like the formula. It looks like the identity of a x minus y whole square. Or if you have seen the same identity in the terms of a and b, that is a minus b whole square. This identity we are going to apply over here. Now, can you tell me what is the identity, like a minus b whole square or x minus y whole square's identity?
A square minus 2ab plus b square.
A square minus 2 into A into B plus B square, okay, plus 1 is equals to 2x minus 3. Let's do the simplification. It became x square. 2 into x into 2 will be minus 4x plus 2 square is 4 plus 1 is equals to 2x minus 3. Okay, now x square minus 4x, 4 plus 1 is 6, is equals to 2x minus 3. Now only we have discussed that whatever will be there on the other side, we are going to transposing it to the left hand side. Okay, so let's take it x square minus 4x. This 2x, when we will transpose it, shift it towards the left hand side, it will be, shall I write plus 2x over here?
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Ma'am, in the third step, it's supposed to be x squared minus 4x plus 5, right?
Oh, yeah. It will be plus 5. It will not be 6. Yeah. Thanks for telling me, okay? Otherwise, we would have gone like that. And this 3 and 6, again, we would have added after that all the steps. Will be incorrect just because of this calculation error. Yes, it will be 5. Okay. So x square minus 4x, this 2x, if we are going to shift it to this side, it will be plus 2x or minus 2x in this side?
Minus 2x.
Exactly. It will be minus 2x on this side. I'm going to write it beside x only so that we can again like terms we are having and we can do the simplification. Plus 5 we are having and that negative 3 will be? Negative 3 will be? This 3 positive 3, right? Is equals to 0. Is it clear to everyone so far? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now? X square, what we'll be having, please tell me. X square
minus 6x
minus 6x
plus 8
plus 8 is equals to 0. Is it a quadratic equation?
Yes.
Yes, it's a quadratic equation. Okay. It's in the format of ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0. I said to you, even bx and c is not there, still it is quadratic. Just ax square has to be there. The degree 2, whatever the variable having power 2, that has to be there because that is only giving us the name quadratic. Okay. Let's do the next one and let's see, this is also quadratic, yes or no? Okay, just by looking at the equation, we won't be able to say is it a quadratic or what, because you can see here we have to apply distributive property. Here also we have to apply distributive property and we have to do the multiplication. So let's do it first. Okay, so what are we going to have? X into x plus 1 is what? Aisha?
X square plus x plus 8.
X square plus x plus 8. Other side, what are we going to have? Yes, Harshit, Aisha, Ziana, Maha. Who is there? Galvin. Sumaya.
Ma'am, it will be x square minus 2 whole square.
Exactly. It just looks like a identity, that is a plus b, a minus b. Or if you have learned the same identity, if you have always seen it in the terms of x and y, that is x minus y into x plus y. Okay, the formula is x square minus y square, or the formula is a square minus b square. Okay, let's use the formula over here. Let's apply the identity. Now, by using the distributive property only, we have got this formula. By using the distributive property only, we are having these formulas in hand that it will be a square minus b square. Why we are going to use the formula instead of distributive property? Because every time we are not going to waste our time, because most of the time students one and only one campaign is there. We are lacking, we don't have enough time to complete the question. Okay, even if we know the concept, even if we are sure that we will be able to do, but we were not able to do it since we were not having enough time. So to avoid those scenarios, we have to save time. Like this x plus 2, x minus 2, directly we'll be writing x square minus 2 whole square. Okay, directly we can write it will be x square minus 4. If you are going to apply distributive property, still it will be correct. Okay, but it will consume your time. Is equals to x square plus x plus 8. Everyone, do it in your copy and let me know whether it is quadratic or not.
No, ma'am, it is not.
Ma'am, it's not quadratic.
Okay. Yes, Harshit, you said it's not, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Maha, you also said it's not, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Rest of the student, is it quadratic or not?
No, it's not quadratic.
Okay, Galvin is also saying it's not. Rest of the students, Sumaya, Ziana.
No, ma'am, it's not quadratic.
It's not. Ziana, you?
No, ma'am, it's not.
Can you tell me, Ziana, why it's not quadratic? Why it's not quadratic? It looks like a quadratic equation. Why? Why are we going to say that it's not quadratic?
X power of 2 is not.
Okay, x square?
It's not in the equation.
Okay, once you'll solve it, you are not getting x square, right?
Yes.
Yes, rest of the student. Why it is not quadratic?
Ma'am, because when you transport x square to the other side, it becomes sub minus. So it gets cut by x square and minus x square.
Yes, Harshit, what you said? Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, same answer. Like x square will be cancelled here and it will be like x plus 8. Then we transpose the minus 4, it will be plus 4. It will be x plus 12. So it will not be quadratic equation.
Exactly. We already have seen the name quadratic came from the highest degree of the polynomial has to be 2. Okay, from there only we got the name quadratic. If x square term is not there, then it is not quadratic. If we are going to transpose this x square to this side, transpose this 4 to this side, it will become x square plus x plus 8, and that x square in this side will be minus x square. That negative 4 in this side will be plus 4. Okay, 0. X square gone. After this, we can do the calculation, we can do the simplification, but since x square is not there, it's not quadratic. So even if initially it looked like that, it will be quadratic, because here we are going to get x square term, here also we will be getting x square term, but eventually both just got cancelled and it's not quadratic. So this is how first we will be solving few questions where we have to check whether it is quadratic or not. And we understand clearly that whatever be the extra term, if x square term is not there, it's not quadratic. If x cube term is there, still it's not quadratic. Now, can you tell me if any polynomial is having degree 3, that's called? Which polynomial?
Cubic.
Cubic polynomial, okay. So here also that equation will be called cubic equation, not quadratic equation. Okay, if you will be having x cube also, if you will be having x square also, if you will be having x also, if you will be having constant also, still degree of this polynomial is 3, it's called cubic polynomial. If such equation we are going to get, if we are going to get such equation where you will be able to see x square term, please don't call it quadratic equation. Okay, please don't call it quadratic equation because it's cubic equation. Even if we can see x squared term over here, but that is not going to decide that the name will be quadratic. Name will only be quadratic when the degree is 2. Highest power of the variable is 2. Okay? So this is cubic equation. Let's simplify third one. Do it. Okay? Just do it in your copy and let me know whether it is quadratic or not. Number 3.
Yes, ma'am, it's quadratic.
Who said? Maha, you Maha. Said?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Rest of the student, please do it and let me know. Meanwhile, Maha, you can do this one. Copy it. I'm scrolling up.
Ma'am, it is quadratic.
Okay. It is quadratic. Harshit and Maha is saying quadratic. Rest of the student, do solve and let me know. Rest of the student, please let me know. I am waiting for your response. Meanwhile, Harshit, you do this one. Maha, you do this one. Yes, Ziana, Sumaya, Galvin, Aisha, third one, is it quadratic?
Yes, ma'am, it's quadratic.
Okay, do the fourth one, Aisha. Yes, Ziana, Galvin.
Ma'am, it is quadratic.
Ma'am, fourth one is cubic.
Okay, fourth one is cubic. We will be doing it together. Rest of the student, please do. Sumaya, you have not responded. Third one, have you checked, Sumaya? Are you having any confusion? Can you hear me?
Ma'am?
Yeah.
Ma'am, this is Jenna.
Yeah, can you please
it's a quadratic equation.
Okay, quadratic. And please do the fourth one also. Yes,
ma'am,
Maha.
Quadratic, fourth one is quadratic, ma'am.
Fourth one is quadratic.
And third one is also quadratic, right?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Both are quadratic. Okay, we'll be doing it together. We are going to do
third one is quadratic. I also got it.
Ma'am, the fourth one is quadratic.
Okay. Okay, let's do it over here. The third one, quickly we'll be doing, we'll be applying the distributive property. Distributive property says multiply this with this one and then we are going to multiply it with 3 considering the plus and minus sign, okay? So positive x multiplied with positive 2x, 2x square, positive. X into 3, both are positive. positive 3x is equals to x square plus 1. As I said, just bring everything on one side. So we'll be having 2x square plus 3x minus x square minus 1 is equals to 0. This 2x square minus x square. Okay, 2x square minus x square is just x square. 3x will be as it is and negative 1 will be as it is equals to 0. This is, yes, quadratic equation. Next one. We are having x plus 2 whole cube. Can you tell me what is the formula for a plus b whole cube? Anyone?
Mom, a cube plus b cube plus 3ab.
A cube plus b cube plus 3ab. That's it? Yes, ma'am?
X cube plus y cube plus 3x square plus y plus 3xy square.
Okay. Rest of the student, please tell me the formula, the identity. Aisha, Galvin, Sumaya, have you seen the identity of a plus b? Yeah, please tell me.
A cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube.
Perfect. Okay. Yes, you all are saying it correctly. Harshit, you also said, but you missed one term. Okay. 3ab, 3xy. Yeah. 3xy will be there, but multiplied with x plus y, that term will also be there. Okay. So the formula for a plus b whole cube or x plus y whole cube is a cube. Plus, you can write b cube over here or you can write 3ab in bracket a plus b. Okay, 3ab is multiplied with this a plus b. Let me write it properly. A cube plus 3ab multiplied with a plus b plus b cube. Or you can write it a cube plus b cube plus 3ab multiplied with a plus b. From here only you will be getting that formula, that is a cube plus this 3ab multiplied with a will be 3a square b, and this 3ab multiplied with b will be 3ab square plus b cube. This is the formula we are having. Or if you are writing it in terms of x and y, still the same formula we'll be having, that is x cube plus 3x square y plus 3xy square plus y cube. What about a minus b whole cube formula or x minus y whole cube formula? The formula is like this. When we are having a minus b whole cube, the formula is a cube minus 3ab or plus 3ab. Anyone, what is the formula for a minus b whole cube?
I'm a cube plus b cube
minus
3ab a minus b.
A cube plus b cube or minus b cube?
Ma'am, plus b cube.
Okay, plus b cube you are saying. Yes, rest of the student, will it be plus b cube?
No, ma'am, it will be minus.
We will be having a cube minus 3ab in bracket a minus b cube. Okay, here everything is negative, you can see, but when we will open the bracket minus 3ab, when we will multiply with plus a, it will be minus 3a square b. And if we will be multiplying minus 3ab with minus b, if we will be multiplying minus 3ab with minus b, it will become 3ab square, and that too positive, because minus minus plus. So in this formula, if you have memorized the last step directly, then you must have seen that one is negative, one is positive. Why? Because in the previous step, everything was negative. Okay. And when we did apply the distributive property, then only we have got this one. Okay. Now let's apply the formula over here. Just a second. No? X cube plus 3ab, 3ab in bracket a plus b plus the last term's whole cube is equals to x cube minus 4. When we'll be doing the simplification, we are going to get x cube plus 6x in bracket x plus 2 plus 2 cube is 8 is equals to x cube minus 4. Now, we have to apply distributive property over here. We will be applying that x cube plus 6x square plus 12x plus 8 is equals to x cube minus 4. This x cube will cancel out each other. When we will transpose that x cube in this side, it will just cancel our x cube, okay? And that 4 will be positive 4 in this side. So we will be just left with 6x square. We will be left with 12x. We will be left with plus 8 and we will be left with plus 4 is equals to 0. This x cube and this x cube got cancelled out when you will write it in one side, okay? And yes, it is quadratic. Even though initially we realized that maybe it is cubic, but it is not cubic because the cube terms are getting cancelled out, okay? So this is how there will be question where we have to identify whether the given equation is a quadratic equation or not. Only power 2 of x will not determine that it is quadratic equation. We have to apply our previous knowledge which is related to this concept. Okay, that's why we see that anytime if you have missed any concept in mathematics, afterward you are going to face difficulty. Okay, so you have to be clear with each and every concept. And if it is not clear anywhere, you just find that this concept is not that clear to you, please just go back and make it clear or tell us. We will be explaining it to you so that in future you will not face difficulty. Okay, now we are done with the first concept. Now the next concept over here is there will be word problem, there will be a story problem. And when we will try making an equation, if you have done the chapter 3, okay, if you have already done chapter 3, then you understand that we just by reading the story problem, just by reading the word problem, we will be able to frame, we will be able to make an equation. Here also we will be able to make equation, but after framing the equation, we will realize that we ended up getting quadratic equation. Okay, and rest of the student who have not done the pair of linear equation, no worry. Okay, we are going to discuss this concept from the scratch. Okay. So let me take one story problem. Let me take one word problem. One of the question says the product of two consecutive positive integer is 306. We need to find the integer. Okay. A sentence is given over here. We have to write it in a mathematical form. It says that product, okay, this is how we will always be solving any word problem. This is the best approach to solve the word problem, okay? You are not going to read everything in one go. That will create confusion. So you have to read like this, the product. Product means what? Can you tell me, anyone? Product means which? Yeah, Aisha?
Maha.
Okay, Maha, what you said?
Multiplication.
Exactly. Product means multiplication. The product, the is okay. Product we know in mathematics, product means multiplication. Sum means addition. Difference means subtraction. Okay, so we know that we know that product means multiplication. So the product of two consecutive positive integer. Multiplication between what? Multiplication between two consecutive positive integer. What is the meaning of consecutive positive integer? Consecutive means 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. After 3, just after 3, 4 is there. These two are consecutive numbers. Okay. 2 and 3, these two are consecutive numbers. 1 and 2, these two are consecutive. Just 1, 2 is just after 1. That these two are consecutive numbers. Okay. So this is the meaning of consecutive. Okay. Very next, you can say. Who is sitting very next to the first number? Those two numbers will be consecutive number. So if I am saying, if I am writing, let's say I am writing Mr. A is there, Mr. M is there, and Mr. C is there. So who is sitting consecutive to M? So either we can take this two. These two are consecutive to each other, or M and C are also consecutive. Okay, M and C, these two are also consecutive to each other. So this is what the meaning of consecutive. Okay, next to each other. So here the product of two consecutive positive integer. The product of two consecutive positive integer. Now what is integer? Integer means we know. That's why we have done the chapters. We have done the first, we have done the chapter integer. Then we learned about whole number. Then we learned about rational number. Then we learned about irrational number. Then we learned about real number in whole. Okay. So integer, we already know. Integer means positive number, negative number, zero. These all are integers. Okay. So two consecutive positive numbers we are having. Okay. Product of two consecutive positive numbers. So if you are going to assume the first positive number as a x, can you tell me what will be the consecutive very next positive integer?
Y.
We are not going to assume y over here. If first is x, the next one we have to take in terms of x only. Okay. Yeah,
it will be x plus 1.
Exactly, it will be x plus 1. In our previous chapter, we were taking x and y. Both are different. That is fine. Okay, why that is fine? Because there we were having two equations. In mathematics, whenever you are having this type of equation that x into y is equals to 20, and if I will tell you, please solve it and find x value from here, and please solve it and find y value from here. It is not possible. It is not possible because this is equation in two variable, and just having one equation is not enough. We won't be able to find x value and y value with the help of the given equation xy is equals to 20. Okay, we need a help equation so that either we can go for eliminate one of the variable, or we can still eliminate one of the variable by using the method of substitution. So what we were doing, we were trying if xy is equals to 20 is there, and if I will give you one more help equation, that is let's say x plus y is equals to 10. If I'll give you help equation like this, or anyway, if I give you one help equation where x and y both will be there, then only you will be able to find x and y value. But here, read the question. Only one condition is given. Only one condition. The product of two consecutive integer is this. Find the integer. The product of two consecutive integer is this. If you are going to write x into y is equals to 306, then the other part is saying just to find the integer. Find x value, find y value, which is not possible. We need a help equation. Okay. We need a help equation since we are having two variables over here. So how we are going to assume it? We will be reading the question carefully. It says that these two integers are consecutive integers, and we know that the consecutive integers pattern or consecutive numbers, if we are talking about whole number, if we are talking about integer, the pattern is how? One is there, then the very next is 1 plus 1, that is 2 is there. Then the very next is 2 plus 1, that is 3 is there. Then the very next one, 3 plus 1, that is 4 is there. Okay, this is how we have always seen the pattern of whole number or integer. If here we are having 1, then the next one is 2. How we got this 2? The previous 1 plus 1. Then the next one is 3. How we got this 3? The previous 1 plus 1. The next one is 4. How we got this 4? The previous 1 plus 1. So every time just 1 is getting added to previous 1, and that's how we are getting the next number. That means the consecutive number. So if we are assuming one of the number as x, then the other number in terms of x only we have to assume. Be careful. Why? Because no other help equation, no other help condition is given over here. Okay. So the next consecutive integer will be x plus 1. Now let me know, is it clear to all of you? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We are going to take x into x plus 1, product of two consecutive integer. Now let's say instead of consecutive integer, the statement is like this. The statement is like this, that the product of two consecutive, the product of two consecutive even number. Is let's say 200. Okay, now how we are going to assume? We will be assuming it by looking at the pattern of even number. First even number is 20, next one 2, next 4, then 6, then 8, then 10, then 12. So can you see the pattern? There is a gap of 2. Can you see the pattern? That every time there is a gap of 2 in between even numbers, yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
So if we are going to assume first even number as a x, then the other even number will be x plus 2, because there has to be gap of 2. If this x is 18, fine. The next one will be 18 plus 2, that means 20. So consecutive even number only we have taken. Getting my point? Are you getting it? So we will be assuming x into x plus 2 is equals to whatever is given. The product is 200 or whatever. Getting it? How to make the equation? What about odd number will be given? You check it. The odd number pattern is also, there is a gap of 2, 2, 2. Okay. If we are going to talk about odd number, visualize it. First one is 1. Then 3, then 5, then 7, then 9. Can you see there is a gap of 2 every time? Can you visualize?
Yes, ma'am.
There is a gap of 2. So instead of even number, if the question says 2 consecutive, back to back, next to next, okay, odd number, then we are going to take same way.